Now we have had two chapters on this matter of leprosy. And that's been bad enough, but it's going to get worse in this chapter. The subject here happens to be running issues. Now, that's not very nice, is it? And these running issues represent to us the repulsive pollution of secret sin. Now, we are hearing about a great deal of the pollution of our ecology, but there is a pollution of our souls also, and our minds, and our entire lives, in fact, of our physical bodies. These running sores, they actually are highly contagious and infectious, and they reveal to us the exceeding sinfulness of sin. You see, human nature is an overflowing cesspool and sewer of uncleanness. Not only is human nature defiled, but defiling. And not only do we get defiled, but we defile others. Not only is it corrupt, but it's corrupting. And this chapter here will hold up the mirror to nature, and after one look, no flesh can glory in his sight. Now, may I just say this word concerning this? Leprosy that we've looked at is the worst disease that is imaginable. And you'd think these running issues would be put before it. But actually, what we have here are those things that are contagious. And leprosy actually is not contagious. I have put in my book, the second volume on the book of Leviticus, a discussion, question and answer period with Dr. Liker, who's an authority on leprosy. He was asked the question, what causes leprosy? And here's his answer, and I'm quoting him. Leprosy is caused by tiny germs called leprosy bacilli, which can be seen only through a microscope. The bacilli were discovered in 1873 by the Norwegian Dr. Hansen. That's why leprosy is sometimes called Hansen's disease. Now, the second question that was asked this good doctor was, how does a person get leprosy? And here's what he said, quoting again. The bacilli are present in large numbers in the skin of certain types of leprosy patients. They pass from these patients to the skin of healthy people, mainly by bodily contact. They then enter the skin through tiny wounds and scratches. Only infectious patients, those who have many bacilli in their skin, are able to spread the disease. And then he goes on to say this, that the only way you can keep from getting leprosy would be, therefore, frequent bathing, washing of clothes, and keeping a clean house. And that's his literal words. That'll help to prevent the disease, because many bacilli can be washed away with water and soap before they enter the skin. And he says the most important thing is to avoid bodily contact with infectious cases of leprosy.